Did that little girl just say cunt?
What the fuck?
What the fuck you looking at?
Two cheap shit losers screwing with a car that someone probably worked their ass off to pay for. I gotta tell you, that hurt.
How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the Daily Review, episode number 318. The film I'm gonna be reviewing for you guys today is one of my most anticipated movies of 2010, and that is Kick-Ass. Kick-Ass is directed by Matthew Vaughn, and it stars Aaron Johnson, Christopher Mintz-Plasse, Chloe Grace Moretz, and Nicolas Cage. There's also a nice little supporting villainous part from Mark Strong, and the always wonderful Clark Duke. Anytime I see that guy in a movie, I just thank the heavens that he's in these awesome movies. Kick-Ass is basically the story about this kid named Dave, who after kind of an epiphany with his comic book friends, he wonders aloud to himself, why hasn't anybody ever tried to be a superhero on their own? I mean, you'd think out of these thousands and thousands of comic book readers, at least one crazy person would have wanted to put on a suit and try to fight some crime. And he does just that. He orders a scuba suit online. He puts it on. He tries to fight off these bad guys that are stealing a car. He gets his ass kicked and sent to the hospital. And after kind of a wake-up call, he gets back out there, meets some other superheroes that have a little bit more experience than him, Hit Girl and Big Daddy, and they kind of go out and they destroy some mother effers, to put it lightly. And what you have going here is kind of an action comedy, comic book fanboy film unfolding before your very eyes and coming to life. Kick-Ass is not the movie that these previews are making it out to be. A lot of people I know think this looks very childish, it looks very kiddy, and just jokey, ha ha ha. I'm here to tell you that Kick-Ass is a mashup of profanity and some of the most mind-blowing stylized, ultra-violent action sequences that I've ever seen. A lot of times the movie, in certain action scenes that take place, it feels like a pure adrenaline rush to me. I was sitting there watching some of these things unfold, and these were kind of a series of my facial expressions that unfolded while I watched the movie.
Oh! Ooh!
Oh my god.
Ooh!
Oh, that was sick. Things like that. I think the performances across the board are superb. Aaron Johnson is fantastic as Kick-Ass. He's kind of the more grounded, realistic character because, you know, he can get hurt and things can happen to him. Nicolas Cage is fantastic as Big Daddy. He channels Adam West when he has the costume on, which adds for a lot of laughter. And the movie is very funny. I'm talking about how exhilarating the action scenes are. The film is very funny, and there's a lot of smart comic book references throughout the film, a lot of smart pop culture references. There's even one about Lost, which got my theater cheering at the screen. But I think as far as performances go, the star of the film in my eyes is Hit Girl, and that's Chloe Grace Moretz. She's this 11-year-old girl who says the most profane and vulgar things, and she truly kicks ass throughout the film. I'm going to see how many times I can say that in this review. It's not going to be pretty. She gets the action scenes so right on the money. She's exhilarating to watch. There's a sequence that takes place with Joan Jett's bad reputation that is so awesome to me. The use of music in this film is amazing, but that sequence alone is incredible. There's also an action scene that takes place completely in the dark. The screen goes black for about 5 seconds. All the action is going on. You slowly get to see what's going on, and the way it unfolds is absolutely brilliant to me. The finale to this film is one of the most exhilarating finales I have seen in such a long time. The way they reveal certain things and the way that everything kind of unfolds is pretty masterfully done as far as the comic book action genre goes to me. I think there's a reveal as to a character buys something that costs $300,000 online and you don't really know what it is, but they talk about it throughout the whole film. And by the end, you get to see what it is, and the reveal is pitch perfect. The audience I saw it with went crazy when that happened, and rightfully so, because it's very awesome the way that unfolds. I will say that I do have a few nitpicks about Kick-Ass, but they're so minor that they don't spoil anything about my enjoyment. Most of them involving trying to blend this comic book action violence, kind of like a Kill Bill Volume 1 esque sort of a thing, highly stylized with kind of serious tones to it that fall a little flat to me. There's one in particular where Aaron Johnson's character is kind of confessing his love to this girl that he likes, and it's very serious, and there's dramatic music playing over it, and it feels like it belongs in another movie to me, which is so minor to me. Also, the final line to this film is supposed to have that oomph that a lot of comic book movies have, and it doesn't quite have that oomph that I wish it had, like the ending to Dark Knight does. That final voiceover, Rorschach's final voiceover in the Watchmen film, I think has that, like, yes, like, this was awesome. It doesn't have that to me, even though they say mother effer in the last line, spoiler. It doesn't have that punch that certain superhero films have in the final 10 seconds. Those are so minor, though. Kick-Ass is such a blast. I highly, highly recommend you guys go out to the theater and see it. I definitely want to see it again. I give it a very strong 4.5 out of 5. It's one of my favorite movies I've seen all year, and probably the most fun that I've had at the movies since I saw Inglourious Basterds or Drag Me to Hell. One of the most exhilarating theatrical experiences that I've had in quite some time. So anyway, thank you guys very much for watching. Go out and see Kick-Ass. Go to filmswithfen.com and check out my review for it, which will be up very shortly. I also posted a poll as to what your favorite superhero film is, so answer that in the comment section on my website, and I will see you guys next time.